Hey guys, it's Phil from smilinggardener.com, and today I want to define humus. I got an email the other day, someone asking what is humus, and so today I am going to talk about it. Now, humus is often used interchangeably with compost or organic matter, but they really are not the same thing, although they're derived from the same thing. What humus is it's basically organic matter that has been broken down by microorganisms, broken down by, you know, even starting with insects and fungi and bacteria, all different hosts of functional groups of microbes and insects, until it really doesn't get broken down much anymore. The microbes have, you know, kind of done what they want to do with it. They'll eat it if they have to, like they'll keep working on it if there's no other food, but really they've done what they want to do. And so it's carbon. It's basically described as biologically active carbon chains. It's a very complex molecule because all these things have been working on it. It's very active in the soil, and so that's what it is. And why it's important in the soil, it's for a number of reasons. One is it's extremely good at holding on to nutrients. So like our fertilizers or even just nutrients in organic matter, it keeps those in the soil. And in fact, apparently, that's especially important for calcium because calcium apparently sinks down lower into the soil profile. So if you have that humus up there, it keeps that calcium up there, which is so important for so many plant processes. Another thing would be water. Make sure you can see me here. Water. Extremely good at holding water. It can hold many times its own weight in water. And so, you know, especially if you have like a sandier soil that does, you know, where the water is draining through quickly, if you get some humus in there, it's going to hold a ton of water. Those are the main ones I often think of. Another one would be toxins. It can help buffer toxins, hold on to them and buffer them so that they're not available to the plants. I don't really know the chemistry behind how that works, but that's one thing that I've often read in the soil books. Another one would be air. Air in the soil, just having that humus in there creates soil structure. I could say air slash structure. You know, it just helps create really nice soil structure, whether you have a sandy soil or on the other extreme, a clay soil. Those are the main ones I can think of. I guess the other one would be microbes. I know the microbes have created it, but it also is like a home for them, which is, you know, it creates a nice environment for them to live in. So that's what humus is. It's organic matter, whether it be compost or mulch or any kind of organic matter that's been shredded by insects, broken down by microbes and bacteria until it's just like this very complex, and yet it's this very complex carbon chain that looks kind of like compost, but it's not discernible from, it's just so broken down. You can't tell what it was at the beginning. And then it does these things, you know what? Holds nutrients, holds water, creates air spaces, buffers toxins, and makes home for microbes. And as always, if you haven't picked up my 15 vital lessons for becoming a better organic gardener, you can do that right on the homepage of smilinggardener.com. And I talk about composting, and I talk about the soil food web, and ultimately in getting you more humus. So that is all for, I just wanted to define humus.